Big responsibility to come with saying my body, my temple. I don't drink. I don't smoke. Like, I done became so boring to all of the wrong people. But I'm so interesting to all of the right people. Anything that make me uncomfortable or a challenge, man, if it ain't rough, it ain't us.
Yeah.
So sometimes we have psychological challenges. Sometimes we have emotional challenges. Sometimes we have physical challenges. So listen, I got to learn from what I learn what I need from this situation. Whether it's uncomfortable, unfortunate, look for the positive lining in it and move on.
All right, so first off, we got to say, today is May 12th, 10:30 a.m. Okay, now that we got that out the way. Second, I'd like to wish all the mothers out there Happy Mother's Day. Third, I'd like to say that I've already went through all my lifts. All my lifts in my head, and I already know exactly what I'm gonna train. So I already have everything. I thought about it yesterday while I was doing whatever I was doing. So I know exactly what I'm gonna train today. It's like I've already done it in my head. Starting with back first, because back I feel is a little bit longer than doing legs. So we're gonna be doing back first today, then legs. So starting off, ideally I would love to do pull-ups to start, but I'm still nervous to do that, and I don't think it's worth me risking the fact, risking me getting injured doing those. I don't know if you guys, I told you guys, but I've had a small injury, a stomach injury, and anything like that's extreme overstretching, it bothers my, that injury that I have, the small injury. I'm trying to get it to heal so I can completely heal it, so I can go back to doing those exercises here and there, or moderately. So I don't want to mess it up now while I'm starting to get better. So ideally I would do the pull-ups, but instead we're going to do pull-downs. Actually, you know what? I lied. I actually want to do a rowing movement first. I want to use my energy in the beginning for a rowing movement. So I'm probably going to do, I want to do T-bar rows if it's available. If not, then I'll do overhand rows on the cable machine. Like seated low rows, but, you know, with the long bar. And like I said, if you, you know, if you guys are healthy enough to do free weights, you get more bang for your buck with the free weights. You get better results. And for my people that already have the foundation and have already been working out for a while, like I have, then you don't have to worry because you know what you're doing. You know, you gotta make the muscle work. Anytime you use machines, you gotta make the muscle work and really focus on that mind to muscle connection. Because a lot of people that, even if they've been working out for years, they don't have that mind muscle connection. They don't know how to do that yet, still. So it's gonna, it's something that requires practice over time. And for those that don't know what mind to muscle connection is, it's basically when you're lifting and working out on that certain muscle group, and you're really focusing your mind into that muscle that you're training. So as if you're, if you can close your eyes and get your mind into the muscle and really focusing on squeezing and contracting that muscle, like you're doing a rep, and you're like, say you're training back, and every rep you do, you feel your back contract. You squeeze, you hold, and then you let go slow. Like, you could feel every rep in your back as if your mind is inside of your back muscles. So that's basically what the mind to muscle connection is. Like I said, a lot of people crooked here. I am crooked. A lot of people, they don't really have that. It takes them a while to get that. But once you get it, you don't forget it. So yeah, focus on that, especially with machines. When you're throwing weight around, bent over rows, and you're going heavy, and you're just purely trying to put on muscle, of course, you want to use mind-to-muscle connection on the accessory movements. But on the compound movements, the compound lifts, the dumbbells, the barbells, stuff like that, you want to move the weight, so to speak. And of course, you want to focus on the muscle, the targeting area of the muscle. But if you're focused on getting strong and put muscle on, you want to just move that fucking weight. So we're in different territories, you know. There's different levels to this shit. Right now, I'm on level one. Well, not level one, I'm lying. Right now, like I said, I'm doing high reps for at least a couple months before, so I could see if it's going to give me what, if my body's changing. And I already do see a difference with the high reps. It's making my muscles more defined, you know. But as far as the cut goes, that's all in your diet, you know, because you could be big and have defined muscles, but to be cut, diced up, that's all in your diet. So, you know, that's being in a calorie deficit and eating, you know, clean. You don't have to eat super clean if you're in a calorie deficit, but if you want to really get that crisp look and get that goal, you're better off eating super clean, because even if you are in a deficit and you hit all your calories and stuff, if you eat sweets and you're still in a deficit, you got to understand your body does get inflamed from the sugar. So even though you are in a deficit, you will put on some water weight for like a day or two, and you'll get bloated, because that's what sugar does. That's what refined sugar and all that stuff does. It makes you retain water. So anything with very high sodium or sugar, even if you're in a deficit, you're still going to lose weight. Don't get me wrong, but you will put on a little bit of water weight too, you know, so the scale will fluctuate. So just keep that in mind for those that are doing deficits and are still kind of eating what they want in a way. Because, I mean, but everybody's body's different, but I'm just telling you from experience and from my knowledge, you know, you will definitely put on a little bit of water weight, but you'll still lose weight because you're essentially in a deficit. That's why if you're going to weigh yourself, like how I do it is I weigh myself once a week. I weigh myself every Friday after cardio, and that's when I weigh myself. Right now my current weight is 211. I was down to 206, so I put on a few pounds. Now some of that is muscle, of course, and some of that is water, I'm sure too, because I had a little cheat, you know, hiatus for a little while where I was cheating every day, but not going too crazy, but I was still cheating. So that probably added some water weight to me too. So right now I would say if I didn't do that, I probably would be at like 208 or two or something like that. Only because I know you guys are like, how can you gain muscle doing higher reps? How does that work? Well, you gotta understand something. I took 6 months off, all right? In those 6 months, all I did was cardio. The 6 months gave my muscles a whole lot of time to recover and heal and not be stimulated by anything. I didn't even lift a dumbbell, I didn't do a push-up, I didn't do nothing. So when I come back in here, basically, as soon as I touch some weights, it's just like, almost like newbie gains all over again. When you're a newbie, you're fresh, your muscles are fresh, you're going to make gains pretty rapidly. But unfortunately for me, I've been in this game for a while, so my body knows, has muscle memory as well, so it knows how much I usually push it. So high reps is different for my body. I usually never go 20s on everything, especially compound movements. So this is like a whole different dynamic for my body than it's used to. It's used to pushing heavier weights, 8 to 12 reps for compound movements, I'm saying. So this stuff is new to me. So even though I'm not doing what I would usually do, it's the fact that I took the 6 months off. My bodies haven't been stimulated, and so my muscles haven't been stimulated in so long that as soon as I come in here, even though I'm doing high reps, it's still getting stimulation to the muscles and it's still growing because it hasn't been stimulated at all. So growth is happening. Now, am I going to gain 10, 20 pounds of muscle? Probably not, especially doing high reps. But I am going to put on some type of muscle. I'm going to put on some muscle, and I'm going to get cut at the same time. So, I mean, I'm going to get more defined, so to speak. So that's what the high reps come into. And, you know, but ideally, what you would like to do, what I would like to do, and what I would suggest anybody to do is put on as much muscle as you can in the wintertime within reason. You don't want to get sloppy fat. You know, you want to try to stay. You can be in a calorie surplus, but I wouldn't go over 500 more calories than what you would usually do, what your maintenance calories are. You can do more than that if you want, if you think you can handle it and you think you can be able to cut that shit down, because cutting is a lot harder than bulking. I'm sure everybody knows that. So you got to be careful with that, especially when you're natural. If you're on a shit ton of juice or whatever, I'm not even going to get into that, but I'm sure that shit does a lot of the work for you, so you don't have to worry as much. Still going to put the work in, but there's a lot more shortcuts you get, have access to, and a lot more drawbacks too down the road, so just remember that. But yeah, the ideally would be to put on some muscle, as much muscle as you can in the winter, stay within reason of your calories, and as soon as springtime comes, start cutting in springtime, because it'll allow you to have enough time by the time June comes to be able to, you know, start peeling back. You know, I would actually say start the cut towards the end of the winter. The end of the winter, start the cut, because it's going to take a while, especially if you don't want to cut aggressively. Cutting aggressively is not easy. And it sounds easy. You can do a crash diet and lose weight fast. But sustainable-wise, by the time summer comes, believe it or not, you're going to be fiending. You're gonna be wanting to binge, I'm telling you now, especially all the cookouts and stuff. That way, if you do it slowly, you'll be all set and your body won't be in such a shock, and you'll be able to sustain that for a longer period of time. So put muscle on in the winter. At the end of the winter, you know, start fucking cutting. That way you're ahead of the game and it won't be as hard and strenuous on your body. Now, I'm not telling you what to do. I'm giving you advice. I'm not a doctor or anything, but you guys can do what you want with this advice. You know, it's up to you. You want to cut it hard and heavy? Go ahead. You want to do it gradually and slowly, which is more healthy for your body, more optimum? I would suggest that, you know, because that's the best way to go about it. And then when you start cutting, then you start, what I would do is just keep the heavy movements, the heavy compound movements. That way you keep your muscle, because when you're cutting down, not only are you're going to lose some type of muscle regardless, no matter how you look at it, because when you're losing weight, you're losing fat. You're cutting calories, you're going to lose some type of muscle, but you want to retain as much of it as you can. So if you can possibly keep your protein high, you know, you're in a deficit, try to keep them compound movements high as well. Try to keep them compound movements 8 to 12 reps. You know what I'm saying? Because pushing a heavy weight while coming down on a cut, it's going to keep your muscles round. You're going to retain as much muscle as possible. And then on the accessory movements, you want to do high reps. You want to try to keep it high reps, 20s on the accessories. That's going to get you cut. It's going to keep your muscle mass and all that. So That's exactly what you want to do. Now, I'm going to go in here. I'll start with some rows. Then I'm going to do a pull down. Then I'm going to do another row. Then I'm going to do a pull over. That's my goal. And then I want to do some leg extensions, leg curls, and then go over to that squat machine that I did last week. And then end with some calf raises. And then that's a wrap. So let's get in there and get it done. All right, so I've already warmed up with 85. Put it up to 115. I did 20, which probably wasn't smart to do, but it is what it is. So this is seated low rows. Basically like a barbell row, I put it because I got the long bar I'm using. Like I said, if you guys are healthy enough, do bent over rows with the barbell, get way more bang for your buck. But I'm using this, and with this I'm gonna try to focus, contract, and squeeze in the first, I don't know, 10 to 12 reps, and then I'm just gonna do them regular with the last 10. So 20 reps here, contract and squeeze. This works the mid upper back, gives you that thickness. So make sure when you do these two, you get a good stretch. You want to stretch your lats out all the way and keep your feet planted and your knees slightly bent. All right, don't hurt your back on these neither. So stay braced because you will hurt your lower back. T-ball row was taken, so we have to opt for this. This is fine though. Oh, shit. Oh, good stretch. Good weight right there. One or two more like that. Whew. One more like that. Oh.
What?
All right, that's good here. Let's go to some V-bar pull downs. This exercise works the lower lats, but works the width of your lats. Anything pull downs works the width. So 15 to 20 reps. A couple more here. One more like that, man. Go up one. It's gonna be harder, but if you don't push yourself, you're not gonna go. What are you doing? You know? Come on up. So right here, I usually like to go use the other machine in the other room. You guys know the machine that I like, but I feel like doing this machine today for, you know, we'll do parallel rows, which works the outside of the lats. And it's almost like, I can't say it's almost like dumbbell rows, but think of dumbbell rows being fixed where you can only do it just facing parallel and bringing it to you. I'm gonna do these right here, both hands at a time. Contract and squeeze the first 10, and then you know the rest, pump it out. So 20 reps, 15 to 20 reps, a couple sets here, and then we're going to pullovers. Ah, shit. Nice. Probably can go up one more, but this pad really fucking constricts your chest, like constricts your breathing because you got your chest so tight on this pad. So that's the only thing that sucks about doing these, but we'll do maybe one more here and then pullovers. So yeah. So we'll do one more here. Then we'll go to some pullovers. Went up from 100 to 115s. Come on. So pullovers, it's all about the stretch and the contraction at the bottom. Same thing, this works like the rib cage part of your lats, so you can see when you do a lat spread from the front, works that thickness. So 10 squeeze, contract, and 10 all out, you already know. So it's too light. Fuck. I usually do these with the rope or something, but decided to do this today. What the fuck? All right, so that machine was working. Pins weren't going, pins were going in, but the weight wasn't coming up, so I'm gonna go right here. Drop set. Triceps and anything, but fuck it. Let's go to legs, man.
So, I was about to say it now. 15 to 20 reps. Same deal. Squeeze. I'm gonna point the heels up for the same duty.
Amazing mothers, and I'm not sure where it came. If I can get them in my effort, I'm going to do this.
Rose.
It's more like that, honestly. I think the emergency is done. The mother's already crying. So, two more here, and then we'll do the emergency care version. Call it a wrap. I'm going to cry for you. All right. One more like that. See, this controversy, these photographs, some say through eye webs. Excuse my track. Some say through low webs, heavier weight, because we walk on a, we walk on our calves every day, all day, they go heavier weight. Man, I say switch it up. You do what works best for you. Caps and for traps. Who's the trap?
Oh, So it's crazy because I never used to work out on Sundays. I was either resting or I'd come and do boxing in here. They got a boxing gym in here. And over here I'm training and posing on Sunday. So it's crazy how life can change, you know? You just never know. But we did back first. You know, we did the wide ball.
Hey, you want this light on in here?
Nah, that's cool, bro. Thank you. We did the wide ball for the rows, seated rows, for the thickness of the back. Then we did, from there we went to V-bar pull downs for the lower lats, the width. Then we did rows again, parallel rows, for the width and the thickness of the back. Then we ended with some pullovers to do the thickened rib cage. Then we went on to legs, laying leg curls, cheeky extract, which my hamstrings are still on fire. And we did leg extensions. Then we did calves. So I don't have the biggest calves in the world. So I actually don't have to think my calves are big because I don't have the best calves. So, but let's show the back pump first because we did that first and spend the most amount of time since we've trained it. So let's show what we got. If we even have a pump still, I don't even know. Size today more than usual because I had a fry last night. Well, I was in a calorie deficit, but having that fry wasn't a good decision because whole water on my size, of course. So that didn't help. Definitely didn't help. Not a good choice. Won't make that mistake again. So let's turn to the back. I hate that. I really do. Actually, you gotta do this one. Composure might even bring the composure down.
So, workout complete. workout is complete, and it was a good workout. Back was really good. Legs was pretty good. Pretty good workout overall. What I had liked to did some squats, of course, but like I said before, we don't want to be, well, you don't really want to, there's no need to overtrain the muscle if it's been completely stimulated and you feel that it definitely has been worked. If you feel like you've stimulated muscle growth and you pushed yourself, there's no need to do overkill, because overkill is not going to do anything but bring everything backwards. You start going backwards at a certain point instead of going progressing. So I feel that after leg extensions and leg curls, my legs were pumped to the max. There's no way I could put any more blood into those muscles. The only thing that would happen is I would just fatigue myself by doing the squats. So I said, you know what? We're not even going to do the squats this week. We'll do them next week. I do the machine squats, but I'm just saying, I'll just do them every other week, or I'll do them every week. Depends on how I feel. If I feel good, I'll do them. If I feel like I've already did what I went there for and my legs are annihilated, I'm not going to do them, because it's not going to make a difference if I do them or don't do them. You know what I mean? And here's my family right here. I'm about to say hello to, because it's that time of the day. I want to say hello to my people real quick. What are you doing?
Me?
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah.
I don't know. I just left the house. There was a man on the back door, and I peeked out and peeped balloons in those fucking doorways.
Oh, that's cool.
I thought it was Eric, so I ran out the front door.
Oh, yeah. Sweet. Yeah, so I was talking to my brother-in-law and my mom. It's Mother's Day. Oh, shit. My mic. I almost forgot my mic. So, yeah, I went to talk to my brother-in-law and my mom. I left my mic in my pants. I don't know if you guys even heard what I was talking about. But I seen them and I pulled over to talk to them. You know, it's Mother's Day and stuff, so. But, yeah. Workout complete. Sunday, Mother's Day. I'm gonna try to take my mom out to eat later. And but right now, well, I wanna take her to this place she used to go to back in the day. She used to love. She hasn't been in a while. I haven't been in a while neither. They got the best clam chowder, fucking prime rib. Perfect day for a prime rib too after training back and legs. So hopefully we can get in there. You know how that goes on Mother's Day. But we'll see. Got breakfast waiting for me at home. I got a protein banana bread that I made. I made it a couple days ago. I put it in the freezer and took it out last night to let it unthaw. So I'm gonna throw that in the oven, and then I'm gonna have my eggs. I'm gonna have an egg and cheese on a bagel, and then I'm gonna have the hash brown, a couple hash browns. And then the banana bread, the protein banana bread, that's gonna be perfect. So, 51 degrees, pretty nice out, a little overcast, but I'll deal with it. As of right now, maple waffle. Damn. It's like extra sweet today, I don't know why. It tastes like extra, extra sweet. Mm. I actually put the maple waffle protein in to the banana bread. So you know how good that's gonna be. I thought about it when I started making it 3 days ago. I already had thought about having it for breakfast. You know, put it in a skillet, a little bit of butter, put some whipped cream on top with some real organic syrup, the eggs, hash brown bagel, perfect post-workout. for a cheat day. My calories are going to be higher today, of course. And then back on track tomorrow. Back on track. Oh, so I've been really tracking my calories now. All right. I decided to track my calories. So everything that I eat, I track, except for Sundays. I don't track it. Sunday's my day to relax and chill. But Monday through Saturday, I'm tracking my calories. And yeah, we're stepping it up, man. We're stepping it up. I'm not tracking the carbs and the fats. I keep an eye on that stuff. I do keep an eye on that. But I haven't been tracking that. I just mostly track the calories. But I keep in mind and I'm mindful of the fats and the carbs as well. So, yeah. I like it. I really like it. Because the way I'm eating during the week, I can see how many calories I'm able to go. And that way, it's so much more stress off my mind. I don't have to be like, oh, I might have went over. Or I might have not had enough. I know by tracking. Like, all right, so I'm not using a calorie tracker app. I'm actually tracking the calories by reading the packages. How you doing? By reading the calories on the packages. You know, and I know people's going to say, well, that's not accurate. It's not always accurate. Well, I round it off, okay? It's accurate enough for me. And I don't really have that much different stuff anyways. I have pretty much the same thing every day. So I know exactly what's in it. And the stuff that I don't know, that's why we have Google, my friends. Google, you know? And say I want to track, I don't know. Like, I'll say, how many calories in one cup of eggs? I'll track it. It's like one something, right? How many calories in one whole egg is 80 calories? Or something like, yeah. So I'll track, if whatever I don't know, I'll Google and I'll track the calories like that. Just like a banana, watermelon, you know, 100 grams of watermelon is 30 calories. So I will weigh the watermelon. Yes, I've been using a scale too on certain things, not all things. I've been using a scale and I weigh my watermelon and I say, all right, there's 100 grams. 100 grams really isn't a lot. So that's why I like watermelon too a lot, because watermelon is like low calories, just like strawberries are, but it's mostly water. So I figured you could have like 500 grams of watermelon. It'll be 3, 6, 9, 12, 150 calories. You know what I mean? So watermelon also makes you more full when you're on a cut or you're on a diet. It fills in the gap in between your meals. If you really want something sweet and you want to quench your thirst at the same time, really good filler to have in between. I'll tell you guys that much. So yeah, I've been tracking my calories Monday through Saturday, and I feel so much better. I can sleep better at night. I don't have to stress. And my calories, I'll tell you right now. My calories is like 2,500. Hold on. Let me do the math real quick. I'm going to do the math because right now I'm 211. But I want to go below that because I want to lose weight. So let's just say I'm 207, right? Or let's say 208. So you do 15 times 208. It's 3,120 calories. That's my maintenance calories to stay the same size, not gain weight or lose weight. Subtract 500 from that. 2,620 calories I'm able to have and be able to lose weight and be in a deficit. But if I want to lose weight a little faster, I'll subtract a couple hundred from that. 2,420. So I've been going up to like 2,000 calories. Sometimes I'll go up to 1,800 calories. I've been staying around the 2,000 calorie range. But if there's a day where I'm extra hungry and I have 2,400 calories, I'll be fine. I'm still going to be in a deficit. You know what I mean? So this is so good for my mind mentally. I don't have to stress or worry as much anymore. I can really track my calories, and I'm mindful of the fats and the carbs of all that, of course, which I don't have much of during the week. So this helps a lot. And plus, I do the intermittent fasting too, which does help. But with this, I don't have to stress or worry. And what another thing that's been helping me out is the Prime Protein Bites. I don't know if you guys ever heard of it, but I did a review on it on one of my shorts. Prime Brownie Protein Bites is like, it's like a sweet tooth craving for brownie. Put that with some fat-free whipped cream on top. Listen, easily fit that into your daily calories, whether you're on a cut or not. And I just have one of them because it has the sugar alcohols. So I just have one. But I'm saying that's been helping me a lot with my sweet cravings, a lot. So shout outs to Prime Brownie Bites. I'd rather do that than to go off and have something real, like a real cookie or real brownie during the week, because I'm not supposed to be having that. And the sugars are way lower in that brownie, and the calories are only like 220. So depending on which brownie you get, 220 to 250, doesn't go no higher than that. So yeah, that's been helping me out a lot. The watermelon, man, this cut is great. I can't even complain. The only thing, like I said, is if you have fried food, which I did yesterday, I went to Chick-fil-A. I got a grilled chicken sandwich with the 12-count grilled nugget, and I counted my calories. It says the calories on it. And I even took the sauces out because the sauces added up calories crazy. So with all that, and then I had a waffle fry. I was craving a fry. I have waffle fries at home. Sometimes I make them in the air fryer if I know I'm going there, and I'll bring it with me. But I said, fuck it, because I didn't know if we were going there or not. I was going to go all the way home, cook that. That makes no sense. So I got a medium waffle fry, and they fucking packed it. But I ate the whole thing, which probably wasn't the smartest thing. I shouldn't even have got it, to be honest. But I got it because I was in my I was in the deficit still. It was in my calories, and I ate, and I enjoyed that shit. But today, I noticed I got extra water on my body. I'm holding extra water because of the fried food, because it was fried, deep fried. So these little things, even though you're in a deficit, like I said before, it will affect your physique. It'll, you know, even though you're still losing weight, it will affect, you'll just be holding more water. But you're still going to be losing weight. So it just, the extra water probably will bring scrub a little bit, but it'll make you look more watery than anything. So it only lasts like a day or two, and then it goes away. So just, but don't, I suggest don't eat any fried food, you know, on a cut, unless it's your cheat day or something, then that's different. And even with the cheat day, I wouldn't say go crazy on a cheat day like that. And that's another thing that's been helping me with the protein brownies and stuff. It's been helping my sweet cravings, so I don't go spiral out of control on my cheat day and have crazy amounts of sweets like I used to, because I didn't have any sweets during the week. I didn't really contribute to my sweet tooth because I'm trying to be so strict. It's not the best thing to do, you know, especially if you have a sweet tooth, because then the cheat day, you will fucking go crazy and have like 20K calories. And that's the last thing you want to do. We're not counting calories on cheat day, but I'm just saying we want to try to stay within reason as well. Like, you know, I'm not going to say only eat whatever you can handle, you know what I mean? Don't have to force it, because you get one every week, so there's no reason to force it. And we're trying to go after the main goal, which is how we look, how we want to look, and how we want to feel. So we have to keep that shit in mind. But Sundays, for me, I enjoy myself, you know, and I try not to go too crazy or overboard. But, you know, there's no telling. But nah, you gotta be mindful. Just be mindful, that's all. Oh, fuck, so good. So that's gonna wrap up today's video. I'm gonna go inside, I'm gonna make my breakfast, and I'm gonna see if I can get a reservation to get, so we can get in that. The place is called Mike's. They got seafood, they got prime rib, pizza, clam chowder, which is the best. So I'm gonna try and get in there today, probably about 3-4 o'clock p.m. It's 12 right now. So hopefully we get in there. We should be good though. But I appreciate y'all for watching. I love y'all. Have a wonderful day and happy Mother's Day to all the women out there, all the ladies. And have a wonderful day. Enjoy your day. And God bless you guys. Peace.